Hi, my name is Lawrence with FRRE and Renewable Energy, and welcome to Frederick, Colorado, in a nice, cloudy, rainy day here. And we're today with my crazy daughter, Kayleen, and we're going to take you on a mini tour through my house. And I'm going to show you simple techniques and ideas that I've used in my personal residence to take my usage from electricity from 526 kilowatt hours a month in the year 2008 to currently 275 kilowatt hours in the year 2010. So without further ado, and before we get really soaked here, let's go inside. Come on. Welcome inside my personal residence. I'm going to be talking about three different devices that I use personally every day in my life. They are the CFL, the nightlight, and the power strip. I'm going to be going through each one separately, showing you its usage, its benefits mainly, and charting on those devices and show how it can help in your house as well. Let's go. Here's a handy dandy device I like to call the kilowatt meter. It measures the volts, measures the amps, the watts, the hertz, and the kilowatt hour usage of the device you currently have plugged into it. All right, the first thing I'd like to talk to you about are power strips. I currently have six devices plugged here into this power strip. I have a light up there below the cardboard. I have a 17-inch monitor. I have a router. I have the speakers. I have the main computer box. And I also have a printer. What power strips basically do is allow the user to isolate the circuit of several devices. And I particularly have this power strip going to my handy dandy kilowatt hour meter again. Let's talk about something called a phantom load. It's called many things, ghost load, vampire load, standby load, all the same thing. Basically what a phantom load is the amount of power still being drawn from the circuit from an item. Your printer, your monitor, your microwave, your TV, whatever it may be, even when it's off, it's still drawing a load from that circuit. And we're going to take a look at that using our handy-dandy device, the kilowatt. Let's check it out. Okay, so before we go any further on the phantom loads, I want to first take a reading off the kilowatt of my computer system. I've had plugged into it for almost a week, so I can take the readings and plug that into my home energy analyzer system. So we're going to plug our magic button, the kilowatt hour button. It's used a total of 2.41 kilowatt hours of power over the course of 126 hours. So I'm going to go ahead and write those numbers down, and I want to plug that into my home energy analyzer system software later and show you how all that works. Okay, we're going to talk a little bit about phantom loads right now. I'm going to use a TV here in my entertainment center as an example. I have a 42-inch LCD TV, just a Technics stereo console here, and a VCR on the bottom, and they're all plugged into a power strip, which is going right into the wall. So I'm gonna go ahead and break out the kilowatt and we'll show you how all this works. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and plug in the kilowatt meter and show you how all this works. Go ahead and Kayleen and unplug the cable from the power strip. Plug in the kilowatt meter. It's gonna take a couple seconds to sense the circuit. Okay, we're gonna hit the watt button up top there. It should read zero because right now it's reading the power coming from the circuit. Now we're gonna go plug in our sixplex, our power strip. It's going to take a few seconds to sense that circuit. And what you're seeing right now is actually phantom load. The TV's off, the stereo's off, and the VCR is off. So it's drawing right now 18, 20 watts. It's up to 23 watts right now. It's constantly flickering, but it's also constantly drawing power. And I'll show you how to use those numbers here. Okay, before we go any further, I'd like to do the main thing we're doing this whole experiment, and that's to kill the phantom load via the power strip. Go ahead, Kayleen, and shut that power switch off. You see our vampire load went from 18 up to 23 watts down to 1 watt of power. So that is the purpose behind the power strips. I currently have 4 power strips in my home. I have them on 2 sets of TVs and 2 computer units, and I shut off the power strip every time we're done with that device, hence saving the vampire loads going throughout the house 24/7. Yes, this is still the saving video for energy. However, I took it outside and we're going to take a reading of the pond pump that I have here, what the kilowatt meter. Okay, go ahead and unplug that cord there. Plug in the kilowatt meter. And plug in the cord again from the pond. And set the kilowatt meter to read watts. It's going to take a few seconds here to calculate the power of that. Okay, and the pond pump is using about 50 watts of power. That also is 24/7. So let's go ahead and calculate out the kilowatt hour usage of this device as well per month. All right, let's go ahead and calculate the kilowatt hour usage of the pond pump for a month, for instance. You start with the watts, which was 50, times 24 hours a day, times 30 days a month, if you have a total of 36,000 watts of power it's using in a month, divide that figure by 1,000, and that will give you 36 kilowatt hours of usage a month. Let's now take the same calculation on the standby load for the TV. 23 watts of power it was using, times 24 hours a day, times 30 days a month, equals 16,560 watts of power in a month, divided by 1,000. So, in standby load only, it's using 16.56 kilowatt hours a month, and the TV, the stereo, and the VCR is off. So you start to multiply this out through your house of all the small devices that are in there, it starts to add up to quite high loads and high usage, and that's just phantom loads. Here's just one more example of the high cost of phantom loads. For instance, one of the worst devices for phantom load powers are plasma TVs. Plasma TVs can use upwards of 100 watts of power in standby mode, in phantom mode. So let's calculate that out. So we'll take our 100 watts of power times 24 hours a day times 30 days a month, comes to 72,000 watts. Divide that by 1,000 to get the kilo part of it. So the plasma TV in standby load, not even being turned on but still plugged into the wall, is drawing 72 kilowatt hours a month. So it's very important to start using power strips for all your devices like this, because it will cut the phantom load off to virtually zero, and you'll be saving all that energy to put towards something else. So we've learned quite a bit about phantom loads and using power strips. Let's go to the next section, a really simple thing you can do, only cost about $5. It's called a nightlight. Let's go check out nightlights. Okay, let's talk about nightlights. For instance, here is our master bathroom. We have 6 bulbs. Each bulb is rated at 40 watts. So you have 240 watts of bulbs up here. But if you come down here to the side, you'll see a handy little device called a nightlight. It's rated at only 5 watts. 5 watts of power is plenty of light to see at night for most bathroom activities you may have. So basically, 5 watts going to 240 watts is kind of a no-brainer in my eyes. We use night lights in 3 different rooms of our house. You can also use them in hallways and that sort of stuff when a little makes more sense. So as we can see, a night light is a very simple device, very cost-effective. They only cost $3, $4, or $5. And you can use them in most places around your home, save you lots of kilowatt hours a month, lots of money over the years. Next device I'd like to talk to you about, I'm sure we've all seen them before, the CFL, the compact fluorescent lamp. They use about 1/4 the power of a standard bulb, and they last anywhere from 7 to 10 times as long. Since we're talking about CFLs, I thought a really good demonstration would be to come to the shop where I have this fixture set up of 6 light bulbs. On the far left is a 40-watt CFL. We have a 40-watt regular bulb. There's a 60-watt CFL, 60-watt regular bulb, 75-watt CFL, and a 100-watt CFL. I'm actually going to plug this into a kilowatt meter, and we're going to go through the bulbs one at a time, and you can actually see the wattage usage of each bulb. All right, I'm going to go ahead and plug in the kilowatt meter on the wall. That's what finds the circuit. I'm going to plug in my light cord now for the fixture, and I'm going to set it to watts. Okay, should read 0. Okay, here is a 40-watt CFL. It's reading 10 watts. I'm going to shut that off and stick in the 40-watt regular incandescent bulb. It's drawing 41 watts. Here is a 60-watt CFL after it resets. Here's a 60-watt CFL, 12 watts. Here is a 60-watt regular incandescent bulb, 62 watts. Here is a 75-watt CFL bulb, 18 watts, and here's the 100-watt CFL. I'm now going to turn on all the CFLs, the 100-watt, the 75-watt, the 60-watt, and the 40-watt. So all of those bulbs together are drawing about 58 watts. And I'll just show you real quick. 100 watt, 75 watt, 60 watt, and the 40 watt. Alright, we're going to be winding down the video here, but I'd just like to spend a few minutes showing you some of the charting software that I've done. What you're looking at right now is the power usage chart, which is the charting software for the home energy analyzer system. I'm not going to go through a whole lot of detail on this chart right now, but I do like to show you how this chart actually works using the numbers that we took earlier while checking out the computer system via the kilowatt. Okay, so to calculate our kilowatt hours per day, we take the total number of kilowatt hours, which in this case was 2.41 kilowatt hours, divided by the total number of hours, which was 126, which came straight off of the kilowatt meter, if you recall. So let's go to our calculator. Let's go ahead and type in 2.41 kilowatt hours. Divide that by 126 hours, okay, equals 0.0191. We're going to multiply that now times 24 to get the total number of kilowatt hours on the average per day of my computer system. Okay, let's go ahead and plug in our data. On the left-hand side here is the item, so I'm going to type in computer. And then we're going to go over to our left, which is the kilowatt hour a day field, and we're going to type in our number, which came out to be 0.4584. And then I'm going to hit tab, and it's actually going to calculate all the kilowatt hours per month and the year a total, and then the average dollar cost per month and the average dollar cost per year of that device, which in this case was the computer. And that's really how it works. It's very simple. You go through your house with your kilowatt meter and you plug in devices to it, and you take an average reading of it over the course of 3 to 7 days. You calculate it out, kilowatt hours per day, and it automatically spits out your usage per month of that device, the usage per year of that device, the dollar amount per month and the dollar amount per year, and also down here it has a grand total of all your devices you've tested up to now. To get this figure right here, if you actually look on your utility bill, and it's going to be the dollars and cents that you pay per kilowatt hour, and all you do is just plug that number right into that field right there, and that'll calculate everything for you. All right, there's one more chart that I'd like to show you. I call this the Build Monthly Kilowatt Hour Usage Chart. This will be available free of charge, by the way, on the website. You can plug in your own numbers to this and just do your own tracking via this chart. As I get my monthly bills, I actually plug in the kilowatt hour usage for that month. Here's 2007's figures and 2008's. And if you look here, the average for 2008 was 526 kilowatt hours per month for the year 2008. In 2009, I actually started to get serious about cutting my costs and conserving electric, basically in January and February. So if you look, each month is less from what it was the previous year. So in 2009, I averaged 335 kilowatt hours a month. And in 2010, right now we're averaging 204 kilowatt, but that's over the course of 9 months. So if you average that out, we're on track to do about 275 kilowatt hours a month, which is about 50% of what we did in 2008. So this is just the hard nuts and bolts straight from my build usage from my local utility. For those savvy spreadsheet users, I actually made a chart of my data for the 4 years. The blue line is 2007. This is, by the way, is January, February, March. You can see the field down here at the bottom. 2007 is the dark blue line, 2008 is the pink line, 2009's usage is the yellow line, and currently 2010 is the light blue line. So seeing a chart like this is actually pretty neat because it shows you your peak demands, which in the summertime is going to be the AC, and the wintertime is going to be lights and heating and that sort of thing. Thank you so much for watching our video. Hope it was informative to you. Hope you learned a few things about CFLs and night lights and power strips, for instance. But those devices can't replace common sense. Shutting off a light when you leave a room, for instance, can make a huge difference in your bottom line, your carbon footprint, your energy usage, and of course, the dollars and cents that come out of your wallet every month. In closing, I'd like to invite you all to visit the website, which is www.frrre.com. Check out our product section, our link section, the education section. And if you like what you see, tell a friend. Well, anyway, thank you so much, and I'll see you on top.